Unmasking the Satanism of MAGA, A Tale of Irony, Politics, and the Antichrist. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests, and fellow truth seekers, prepare yourselves for an odyssey through the labyrinthine corridors of American politics, where reality blurs with fiction, and the lines between good and evil are drawn in shades of irony. Let us first confront the enigma of Satanism. Does it truly exist, or is it merely a figment of imagination conjured by lonely hearts clubs, eccentric hobbyists, and political provocateurs? I've delved into the depths of cyberspace and emerged with naught but a handful of shock-seeking individuals playing dress-up with dark ideas. Enter Anton Sandilavy, the ringmaster of the Church of Satan Carnival in 1966. Lavey's game was as transparent as a magician's trick, exploiting the disenfranchised, peddling tales of rebellion, and lining his pockets with the coins of the gullible. His satanic Bible read like a manifesto of heartless libertarianism, a mishmash of Ayn Rand and Darwinian ruthlessness. But fast forward to 2024, and institutional Satanism is as elusive as a ghost in the night. Instead, we have the charismatic Lucian Graves, donning the mantle of rationalism and rebellion against the evangelical tide. His satanic temple isn't about devil worship, it's a clever ploy to defend secularism against the righteous fury of the fundamentalists. If anything, this guy defends modernity from darkness. Yet, in the heart of America, a far more menacing storm is brewing. A motley crew of evangelicals, Christian nationalists, and white supremacists, under the banner of Make America Great Again, seeks to reclaim a lost paradise of homogeneity and traditional values. But here's the kicker: they're not exactly walking the Christian walk. Instead, they're strutting down the laven path of ruthlessness, fascism, and anti-diversity. And what about their chief architect, Donald J. Trump? A man of simple desires, vulgar impulses, and perhaps a touch of criminal cunning. Is he the unwitting puppeteer of this diabolical drama, or a maestro conducting the symphony of chaos with a devilish grin? Yes, the possibility that sends shivers down the spine. Could Trump be the Antichrist incarnate? Consider the evidence: his rise to power fueled by the anger of the disenfranchised, his uncanny ability to sow division and chaos, and his insatiable thirst for adulation and power. Could it be mere coincidence that his initials match those of the biblical beast, or that his followers worship him with an almost religious fervor? It's a spectacle of irony, my friends. While the MAGA crowd hurls accusations of Satanism at their foes, they unwittingly embody the very values they claim to abhor. Christian fascism masquerading as righteousness, conspiracy theories as gospel truth, and an antichrist in the guise of a populist demagogue. So, as we navigate the labyrinth of American politics, let us not be deceived by the smoke and mirrors of sensationalism, for in the theater of the absurd, truth is often stranger than fiction, and the devil wears many masks. And amidst this carnival of chaos, one thing remains clear: the only thing more terrifying than the specter of Satanism is the all-too-human capacity for self-deception.